Hello, and welcome to a Grade 4 Mathematics lesson. Today, we're going to work with some money. My name is Mrs. Gessley, and I work for Spokane Public Schools as the Elementary Math Coordinator. Some lessons you will need paper and pencil, and some lessons we will just use our brain. Today's lesson will focus on our brains and not using paper and pencil, although if you get really stuck, you can use some scratch paper. Let's go ahead and take a minute to warm up our brains. Let's take a look at this puzzle over here. They've given us a clue. Their teardrop is equal to 12, and we need to figure out what the trapezoid and what the circle is equal to. If the orange teardrop is equal to 12, then and there are two of them in the mobile, what might the blue trapezoid and the green circle be? Well, I know the number that they all are equal to is 48. And I know that the orange teardrop is 12, and so there's two 12s, which equals 24. Do some thinking while I do some thinking as well. How'd it go? What did you get for the trapezoid? What about for the circle? I haven't solved it yet. Here's how my brain thought about it. My first thinking, if the teardrop is 12 and there are two of them, that equals 24. That means there's 24 left for the trapezoid and the circle. Okay, so if I know that 6 times 4 is 24 and 8 times 3 is 24, I wonder if I can break those down into the factors. Okay, so there's 3 2s and 1 3. Does that fit for the trapezoid and the circle? Does that really help me? I'm still stuck. I'm gonna have to try another way. Well, here's another thing I thought about. If there has to be two trapezoids, 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 6, and 24 minus 6 is 18. Well, I can split 18 in half, so are the circles worth 9 and the trapezoid worth 2? Maybe, let me see. Well, does it work? Can I have the blue trapezoid be 2 and the green circle be 9? Well, that definitely adds up to 24, but are they equal to each other? The puzzle told me no. Well, the math added up, but the trapezoid and the circle are not balanced. 18 and 6 are not equal. So let me try again. If I have 24, I need the circle and the trapezoid to equal 12. That makes it maybe a little bit easier. 6 and 6 makes 12, so the circle could be 6. And so does 4 plus 4 plus 4. So the trapezoid could be 4. Is that what you got? Yay! The mobile is balanced. I did it correctly after some tries. If you want to do more puzzles like this, you can follow the link solveme.edc.org. Now, let's get into today's lesson. Today's lesson is going to think about some coins. How many cents, how many pennies are in a quarter? You are right. There is 25 cents in a quarter. How many cents is there in $1? If you said 100, you are correct. There are 100 cents in a dollar. So how many quarters in a dollar? You might have said 4, and if you said 4, you're right. Here's our last question. If there are 4 quarters in a dollar, how many quarters in half a dollar or 15 cents? 50 cents. So again, the question is how many quarters in a half a dollar or 50 cents? The following problems we're going to do are related to each other and sometimes are easier to figure out if you use quarters to help you. I will put a problem up and ask you to push pause so you have a minute to think about it. Then, when you are ready, click play and see if you thought about it the same way I did, or if you thought about it another way. It might be fun to have a parent or sibling watch this part with you. They may think about the problem in a different way. Remember, mathematicians don't always think about math the same way as their peers. The creativeness of math helps us solve deep problems and challenges. Let's solve this equation with some mental math. 1/2 plus 1/4. How might you solve that? See if you can come up with an answer in your head. Did you solve it? Some students give me an answer of 75. 75 cents is how many cents out of a dollar? Remember, we just remembered 75 cents would be out of 100. How do you think they got that 75 cents? Well, if we know that 50 cents is the same as a half, we can say 50 cents out of a dollar. And then if we know that how much is 1 out of 4, 25 cents, if we're thinking about money, we can say that's 25 cents out of 100. Some students just give me the answer of 3/4. How do you think they got that answer? Well, how many quarters do we have when we look up here? If we have 1/2 of a dollar, which is 2 quarters, and 1/4 of a dollar, which is 3 quarters, that's the same as 3 quarters out of a dollar. $1. All right, let's take a look at this problem. Let's solve 3/4 plus 1/2. I'm wondering, can you do that in your head? 3/4 plus 1/2. Did you solve it? What? Did you use pennies or did you use quarters? So let's look at it. If we use quarters, we have 3 quarters out of a dollar, and then 2 more quarters, because remember, 1/2 is the same as 2 quarters. So 3/4 plus 2/4 is how many quarters? 5 quarters out of a dollar. And if we say 5 quarters, how much money is that? Is that $1.25? Well, if it's $1.25, or it's $1 and 1 more quarter, we come up with an answer of $1.25. And how can we rewrite that? We could say $1.25 out of 100. Or we say $1 and 1 quarter out of four quarters. Sorry, $1 and 1 quarter out of 4 quarters, which is the same as 1 1/4. Did you get one of those answers? All right, here's our next one. We have 1 3/4 plus 1 1/2. Did we just do one that was similar to this? 1 3/4 plus 1 1/2. We just did one very similar to this. We just did a problem that said 3/4 plus 1/2. And what did we have that equal again? 1 1/4. Well, if we know that this part is 1 1/4, can we add the other 1 to our whole? So could we say 1 1/4 plus 1? And what does that equal? If we think about money, that equals $2 and 1/4 of a dollar, or $2.25. So we could look at it too of saying 1 3/4 plus 1/2 equals 2 1/4. Or if we were dealing with pennies, I could say 1 75 out of 100 plus 50 out of 100. And if I think about this, that goes over a dollar, right? If I have 75 cents and 50 cents, that equals the same as 2 and 25 cents out of a dollar. All right, let's take a look at this one. We have 2 1/2 plus 1 1/4. We're having dollars that we're looking at, and then parts of dollars. What do you think the answer to this one would be? How'd it go? Did you look at these as pennies and dollars, or did you look at dollars and quarters? I'm curious how you solved it. If we look at this, I kind of look at it and say, well, I'm going to look at the full dollars first. So if I know there's $2 and $1, I know that that's $3. And then I know that 1/2 is the same as 2 quarters, and 1/4 is the same as 3 quarters, and 3 quarters out of a full is 3 out of 4. So I get the answer of 3 3/4. Could I also say, well, I know that 1/2 is 50 pennies and 1/4 is 25 pennies out of a dollar. And so I get 75 pennies out of a dollar. Are these two equal to each other? All right, this one's getting a little tricky. 3 3/4 plus 1 1/2. Share this one at the dinner table tonight and share how you solved it using your head. This one's getting a little tricky, but we have had some similar ones to it. Did you use the pennies method or did you use the quarters method? I guess I could call them those, couldn't I? So if I look at this and I follow that same method I've been using, I'm going to look at the wholes, which is the 3 and the 1. And so I have that to equal 4. And then I can say plus 3/4 plus 1/2. And did we solve before what 3/4 plus 1/2 is? If I know that 3/4 is 3/4 and 1/2 is 2/4, that means that I have 4 5/4 out of 4. Well, if I have 5/4 out of 4, can I do something with all 4 of those quarters and make it 4 out of 4? I can go ahead and say 4 plus 4 out of 4/4 plus 1 out of 4/4. And what did we decide that might equal? Well, this is $4. How much is this one? 4 out of 4/4. If I have 4/4, is that a dollar? So I have $5 and 1 out of 4/4 left. Is that how you did it, or did you do it a different way? Go ahead and talk with your parent or sibling about how you did it. All right, fourth graders, we have 2 left. This one and 1 more, and they get just a little bit harder each time. 9 1/2 plus 5 3/4. Is there anything about this problem that is familiar to what we've done in the past? How did you solve this one? Did you use the pennies or did you use quarters? I think I'll solve this one using pennies this time. So I know that they're $9.50 out of 100, because 1/2 is 50 pennies. And I also know that 5 3/4 of a dollar, or 3/4 out of a dollar, is 75 pennies out of a dollar. Well, again, I know that there's $9 and $5. And if I think of those two together, I get $14. Now, if I look at the 50 cents and the 75 cents, if I add those together, I have $1.25. So I can say plus $1.25. And again, we know that 25 cents is the same as 14 plus 1 25 cents out of a dollar, which equals $15.25 out of a dollar, which is the same as 15 1/4/4. How's it going? This is our last one. 101 1/2 plus 10 3/4. Think about this in your brain. Your brain can do this. What did you get for an answer? 101 1/2 plus 10 3/4. Well, I think I might look at those two whole numbers again, and I might say 101 plus 10, well, 111. And then I know that 1/2 plus 3/4, if I'm thinking about quarters, that's 2 1/4 3/4 equals 5 1/4 out of 4. So then I know that I need to add $1 up to my 111. So I'm going to get 112 1/4. Man, I almost said 1/2. 112 1/4. Is that what you got? Let's take a look at the problems we did today. We started out with 1/2 plus 1/4, and we decided that that equaled 3/4 or 3/4 out of a dollar. Then our next problem made it a little trickier because it went over 100 cents or over a dollar. But we decided that that one were equaled 1 1/4, 1/4 out of 4. Then the interesting thing is, did you notice this? Take a look at this. If you see this, do you see that same thing right here? And that same thing right here? And what about right here? And right here. Did you see how those all have that same 3/4 plus 1/2? So if we look at the pattern that's happening in here, we have this one that equaled 1 plus 1 and 1 fourth. Oops, let me write that correctly. Let's try that again. 1 plus 1 and 1 fourth, which we decided equaled 2 and 1 fourth. And then this one, what is this similar to when we look at this one? This one, 1 half plus 1 fourth, is the same as this one. So what did we decide that one equaled? We decided if we take the two whole numbers, which equals 3, and then we had 3/4 out of a dollar. So if we come back to our pattern that we had over here, we have 3 plus 1, which is 4, plus another whole one, which is 5, 5 and 1 fourth. And this one we had 14, and another whole one, which equals 15 and 1 fourth. So if we look at this one, we had 111 plus another whole dollar, which equals 112 and 1 out of 4, or 1/4 out of 4/4 in a dollar. Do you see those patterns? Mathematics has a lot of patterns, and that makes math very much fun. Thank you for working on some math with me today. If you're looking for additional things to do in math, the KSPS website will have additional lessons for you to view. There are also some resources on our Spokane Schools website under Learning at Home. Be sure to look under the fourth grade for more fun math choices as well as other subject areas. I have one last math challenge for you as we end today's lesson. How many ways could you use to figure out how many towels there are on the rack?